Hi guys, welcome to episode 2, not episode 1. Someone forgot to change their, the thing at the beginning. Whatever you want to call it. Welcome to Casual Dracula. I am your host, Actual Dracula. And I am delighted and honored to have two very fine members of this comic book community joining me tonight. They are both co-hosts of the popular comic book themed trivia game show Rigged, which if you have not seen, I highly recommend you check it out. They have it's a game show. It's a trivia game show. That's all I'm gonna say. You guys gotta check it out. Anyhow, so we have got the two co-hosts of Rigged. First up would be a guy who you can check out. He does weekly reviews that for me are a great source for figuring out which books are pieces of crap this week, which ones I should just avoid. And that would be Mr. Taylor Winder. Welcome, sir.
What's up, everybody? They're all crap. Well, I mean, honestly.
And we've got fellow Rigged co-host Jason in the house, Mr. Slotted Up 503.
What's up, everybody?
How you doing, buddy?
Doing well. How about you?
I'm good. Excited to have you guys on for episode 2 of Casual Dracula. I think I might just leave the card at the beginning. I'll just change the name of whoever's on, but I'll leave it saying episode 1.
That's a good idea. That way everybody thinks they're the first.
So. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I feel left out with my name now. I missed the memo. Damn it.
I just kind of did this while I was waiting behind backstage. That was the longest intro ever. I had some time to kill, so I was like, let's see. Yes.
We're going to do... this is Casual Dracula. It's not really... I don't really have much of a plan. It's kind of just a free-form conversation. I might have a couple questions about your channels and about Rigged. Maybe we'll even play a game. But before that, I've just got to give a quick shout out to my sponsors. Excellent. Thank you to the Mega Men and Design for Living. Now, before we get into the old chit chat, chopping it up, let's take a minute to see what the chat is up to. Let's see here. All right. First up, we got Jean Mello. First in, Jean is an awesome dude. He does not have a YouTube channel, but if he is in like all the chats, in a lot of, streams that I watch. And I did have the pleasure of chatting with Jean. I guess it was probably, Oh, it was a while ago, maybe like 2 months ago. Anyways, we got to do it again soon. Oh, look at this. We got Ignacio. Ignacio's in the house. We are all designed for living here. I could not agree more. So that would be Ignacio.
Barbara Gordon. You hawk. My name is Ignacio.
that of course was Ignacio calling into the show last week.
Nice.
and here we go, Mr. DJ Lynx, who is just I think he might be stalking me. Every time I turn around, there's DJ Lynx, and I gotta say, I love it, buddy. Keep it up. Also, speaking of DJ Lynx,
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
I don't know. It sounded like it might have been a little bit DJ Lynx in there. I don't know. It says it was Ignacio, so I'll have to take his word for it. Slotted up. Yeah. Good to
Double
see
dipping.
You. Soul Twice. What it do, Pikachu? Yes. I don't know if you guys caught. I did a live stream yesterday where I showed off some drawings that Soul Twice did for me. Yeah, they're awesome. Good guys, got to hit him up for some commission some artwork. He does these amazing chibi drawings. Who else we got here? Whack Comics in the house. Let's go. And that, of course, was Whack Comics you just saw speaking with Ignacio, the one and only. Super Jesse. Hey there, Super Jesse. Brock Morgan, yo.
What's up, Broccoli Monster?
The Brockness Monster.
The Brockness Monster.
Oh, Brock. Brockness.
Brock's got the coolest hats on YouTube.
He does.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
And no one I know that has luck with the Comic Vantage boxes.
Yeah. That's true. Although Comic Food did just, he got a really cool remark to. What was it? A G.I. Joe one. That was pretty nice. Legion of Comics. What up, comic fam? We are Legion. And anyone else new in here? Let's see. I think that's about it. Oh, okay. We got God Tank, Drake, Justin Bieber, and Actual Dracula.
Aww, I'm not sure which one I am, but I'll take. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're Justin Bieber, Taylor. You got the hair.
I can be Justin. I can pull it off. Sure. Yeah,
I think we can all agree on that. Roscoe, what up, buddy? All right. So I think I got everyone so far that's in here. I wanted to ask you guys about Rigged because if for anyone who hasn't seen it, you got to check it out. It's a game show, comic book trivia game show, like I said earlier. So I want to know, whose idea was this, and how is it that you two guys came to be doing it together?
It was actually Taylor's idea, and for everyone wondering, it will be back. I am just taking a little break. I went on vacation, taking a little bit of time off, but it will be back. Yeah. It was Taylor's nephew's idea.
Yeah, kind of, but you turned into something good, and you did all the work. I just I showed up and made fun of the guests. That's all I do.
Well, and you play a very important role.
Yeah. I'm like the Ed McMahon. Wait, that's probably older than no. All my people are middle aged. Yeah, I'm Ed McMahon of the thing.
Or Vanna White.
Yeah.
Or Vanna White. Yeah. Yeah. I was gonna say Vanna White for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's Taylor's nephew's idea, talking about basically who would win in a fight, kind of superhero battle thing. And Taylor mentioned game show, and I am an avid watcher of game shows. I love game shows and just comic books and game shows. So here we are.
Yeah.
And do you guys kind of both come up with the questions?
I really do nothing. I don't do a damn thing. I get the questions like a half hour beforehand. I read through them, and then I just, I make fun of the people when they don't get it right. And that's all I do. So,
so
I have I have a book that I get them from, and then you know, Google, which periodically can be wrong when DJ Lynx tells on me.
Yeah. Or when what's her face? There was one. What was the one? There was somebody that called you out, or that I can't remember her name. She really hated losing. Was that the
Mars?
One? Yeah, Mars hated. Yeah.
Oh,
they both won. They split the.
Yeah.
But that was the evilest look I've ever got ever in my life. Oh, I think.
She gives the same look to anyone who says anything bad about Peach Momoko as well. I believe, right? So your last episode might have been my favorite with Rod the Recon and Bearded Comic Bro. That was
The one I wasn't part of. Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
not because
that's
of
the
that.
Nature of Rick, because, yeah. Adrian's much nicer than I am. He's a nice guy. I'm just kind of a dick.
I totally forgot he took over that day, but it's just Rod was killing me. Like that dude, he's just got a certain way about him. He's hilarious. That was that might be my favorite episode so far.
And every one of the contestants does way better than I would ever do. So
yeah, that's the thing. Like I would love to come on Rigged. I don't know, maybe now that you're on my show, I don't know. See, there's I have some kind of ultimatum here. No, actually,
Rigged. What's up, Biggie?
Rigged. Yes.
What is up, Biggie?
Yeah.
Ever since I saw it, like from episode one, I was like, oh man, I'd love to be on this show, but I know I would just bomb. I don't care though, because it looks like a lot of fun. You are going to be continuing with the show though.
Yes. Like I said, I just needed it, you know, with COVID, you know, we got all this extra free time, and then that's when I really launched my YouTube channel. And
yeah,
I'm one of those people that have that personality that whenever I get it, when I do something, I like to like go gung ho into it. And that's kind of what I did. So I kind of, you know, went overboard. So I just needed to step back a little bit. I'm going to come back periodically here and there. And I want to bring Rig back. And I also, I'm going to bring back Sidekicks.comics with Rob every other week. So I plan on coming back for sure.
Right? Yeah.
I miss you all. I miss Taylor's face.
I miss you too, buddy.
Yeah, as do we, man. I mean, that's why I'm so glad you agreed to do this. So, you know, I was hesitant to ask you. I wasn't sure. I know you wanted to take a little break, but I figured, you know, I might as well see what if he wants to, you know, just come hang out.
Yeah, Rick has a prior engagement anyway. Like we had a show that was coming up before I took my break that we really need to fulfill our prior engagement with Whack Comics. Because we were supposed to be the guest on our own show. So that'll probably be the next episode of Rigged when we could work that out.
Cool.
On the plus side for that, Jason, you don't have to come up with questions. You just got the shit.
Exactly.
Yeah. Like
So here we go. DJ Link suggests Biggie versus Drac on the return episode of Rigged. I'm down for that. Anytime.
But you have to answer in hip hop form. It's got to be a freestyle answer.
Yes.
Yeah.
I suppose it will be, because my comic knowledge is I don't even know at this point. I've read a lot. Have I retained any of that information? I seriously doubt it.
just tell Jace to make it all about 90s indies comics. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
If Biggie's coming on, it's going to be all indies comics. It's going to be all Something Is Killing the Children.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm just messing with you, Biggie.
Bring back slot canceled, Drac. Thank you, Tyler. Yes.
Nice.
A lot of love for Jason here in the chat.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. I think you might have had people a little worried. You had an Instagram post that was
that wasn't even meant to be anything cryptic. Like it actually, after I posted and everybody right. messaged me, I'm like, well, yeah, I kind of get it now. But that was just me taking a break from Instagram because YouTube is a lot of work. But yeah. I'll tell you what, Instagram is like nonstop. Once you download Instagram on your phone and all the different chats you're in, your phone constantly is So I took Instagram off my phone and now I just check it on my computer. So it's like I broke away from that monster for a little bit.
Yeah, I completely understand that. I should probably do the same thing. I doubt that I will, but
what you're saying is YouTube and Instagram are both evil and should be destroyed.
Yeah. I don't know what Ignacio means by this, but
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
See if I can get that in a few more times.
I'm sure you can work it over.
Jean is 62 years old, and I've forgotten more than you three have learned combined.
Plus, John has a name that sounds like he's a hitman, like the right tattoo, Jean Mello.
Yeah,
and he's got Space Ghost as his logo.
Yeah.
So there
you go,
Jean Mello, who is famously known as Jean Mello in the community because no one realizes he's French Canadian, and it is indeed pronounced Jean, like Jean-Luc Picard. Everyone can say that.
Oh, right? Jean-Luc, yeah. He's a decent actor.
Bark at each other, whack. All right, Biggie's stirring up some stuff in the chat. Here we go. I love it. I mentioned in the intro, Taylor, that you do weekly comic book reviews.
I do,
I just watched the one you did today.
Thanks. You're the one.
Great. And I find myself, at least because you read a lot of books, right? You pick up a lot of books every week.
Yeah. The day they come out, he reads them all.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't, but I find with the ones that I do read that you review, I find more often than not, I'm agreeing with your opinion. And there is an awful lot of, mediocrity, out there at times. Although when you just surprised me, you were talking about the new Batman book, which I guess surprised you, because I had stopped reading Batman. I mean, James Tynion's doing some amazing work, really exceptional work, but Batman was not. I found a title that it was not. I read basically after reading the Joker War. I was like, I did not care for that at all.
Yeah, I definitely understand that. It took me. Like this past issue was decent. Don't get it twisted. It's been a slow grind of nonsense with it for the most part. Like, and I do like the some of the nuance he's put in where not every bad guy's truly bad and stuff, but it's just he needs to start getting somewhere. And that's the problem with Tynion and a lot of shit. He'll just take what could be a 3-issue thing and drag out to 12.
Yeah.
I still think it's killed in the children. I love you, but you're slow. Yeah. So yeah.
Well, I read Nice House on the Lake issue 2 yesterday, and that for me it promises to be like probably my favorite book of the year. I think I really really enjoyed those first 2 issues. A lot of dialogue, but I thought the dialogue was felt pretty natural, well written.
Yeah, that's a good one. It was really close to being my book of the week.
Yeah.
I actually just read that today. And then the one I finished recently was because I took a little break from reading as well. Stray Dogs 5, the way that tied that up, that was a great ending.
Yeah,
I haven't read that yet, but
you could bang out Stray Dogs in like 20 minutes. The entire all 5 issues, like,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, yep.
It's a very quick read. Yeah,
but going back, watching some of your older reviews and some of your other videos.
Yeah,
like I see like the kind of the breadth of things that you read because you read a lot of independent books, and you're one of the few channels I watch where you have like truly like independent and like underground stuff. You're reading that almost nobody else is even talking about.
Yeah, I try, and then I get in trouble because the creators get mad at me when I don't praise them. the creator of Shrimpy and Paul sometimes has been trolling me on Instagram.
Oh, really? Mark Bell? Yeah,
yeah, Mark Bell's kind of funny. I mean, it's like the Canadian version of trolling. It's pretty gentle.
But yes. Like, yeah. Yeah. Mark. I've actually got one of his books here. Yeah. Pure Pajamas.
Nice.
Yeah. So this, like, I love Mark Bell's work. It is definitely unique. It's surreal, that's for sure. I mean, there's he's got stuff like this, like just random pages of I wouldn't even really call it a comic. He does comics, right?
Yeah, but he does.
He does a lot of stuff like this as well. But yeah, I noticed, like, because most channels I watch and you know, stuff on Instagram, even people that are really into independent stuff, whether it's due to just not knowing about it, like, because some of this stuff is like hard to find, especially if you don't live, like, you know, in a bigger city. You know, you might not even know this stuff exists. So it's always interesting to see someone that is, you know, kind of finding these smaller press books. You know, I mean,
I don't live in a big city right now. I used to live in Chicago, and I was spoiled because they had one of the best bookstores ever, which is Quimby's bookstores there. And they feature almost solely independent stuff. But
yeah,
you know, yeah. I make a point. I also realize, like, once you stop chasing views on YouTube, it's very freeing. Cause, like, I've gained like maybe 2 followers in the past 2 months, and I stopped caring. Like, DJ's lapped me. Small Town Collectibles is like gonna double my stuff. I get like 20 views on these books, like this indie book. Nobody honestly gives a shit, but I don't care. I'm reading what I want. I'm doing what I want.
Yeah.
Like, it's those 20 people really care.
Yeah, those 20 really do. It's just the other, you know, they don't get any views, and it's fine. I just couldn't keep doing just mystery boxes because, oh God, if you want to burn out fast, just to
I know. It's funny you mentioned that because I wanted to start doing more videos of stuff like that. Like, I'll show you, like, for example, like that, like the Mark Bell stuff, where one of my favorite Toronto creators is this guy, Jesse Jacobs. Here's one of his books.
Oh, nice.
Brawl Space. Yeah, he's an amazing artist. It's from Koyama Press in Toronto. But he does a lot of stuff.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll hunt him down.
You know, there is words as well. But yeah, like, that was one of the reasons I was drawn to your channel, was because you were showing stuff like that, like more, you know, underground comics really than I'm accustomed to seeing anyone else showing off on YouTube and Instagram. And that's stuff that I really, for the past 20 years, I was reading a lot of that stuff as opposed to anything from Marvel or DC. So, yeah.
I think more people are going to head that route. Like, people have been talking. I watched an interview with Small Town earlier, and like he was saying, people are getting sick with DC and Marvel. And I think COVID, everyone immediately jumped to DC and Marvel because it was comforting, you know, and it's like, oh, it's childhood stuff. It's the same characters. But then you realize, oh, it's the same characters. And, like, the nature of the beast is like, there's not a lot of progression and there's no end to a story. There's no resolution to any of it. So, like, I think if you get to some of these smaller stuff and these more personal projects, whatever they may be, they might not all be fantastic, but you at least have a beginning, a middle, and an end, and then arc to a story that's like missing in most, if not all, mainstream stuff.
Well, for me, it was the horror. I like the horror comics.
You know?
And they're having a renaissance right now. There's a lot of horror stuff out there.
Yes, there's a ton of it, and those are the majority of the things that I enjoy reading the most.
Yeah,
horror and post-apocalyptic. Yeah,
yeah. What is that? What is it? Nuclear Family.
Yeah,
that's a really good book right there.
That's a fun one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Soul Twice, I agree with that. Fill your niche because the niche will love and support you. Yeah, at least in theory. Right? And we got Jimmy the Don Kerr in the house. He's on live with Gary B right now.
Oh, he's just basically saying everyone stop watching this and go watch. That's the passive aggressive, subtle mortgage guy way. It's like, oh, that's the rate you're getting from that lender. We can do better.
He just wanted to come on and give me crap for not being on the usual suspect show. Yeah.
That's right. Maybe, yeah, I think I kind of stole you away from that. That's how we do here on Casual Dracula. Nice. Jimmy did just put up a video this morning, his latest 10 questions, which is with yours truly. And I really enjoyed doing that. That's one of my favorite shows. So, yeah, thanks again, Jimmy. Although you're probably not watching this because you are now live with Gary B. Is there a sponsor of this show? It's funny you should ask. Actually, there is.
Yeah, bud.
So yes, to answer your question there, that was the sponsor. Yeah, I can see that happening. I mean, I don't buy a lot of mystery boxes, so for me, I haven't been burnt out yet, but I know a lot of channels, like if that's your focus, I could see that. That's eventually, well, what ends up happening, of course, is you end up making your own mystery boxes to get rid of all those books you got from mystery boxes.
Yeah, that's the Adrian APM video where he talks about the progressions. Yes.
That was excellent.
Where we basically all just exchange comics and money.
Yeah,
that's for months and months and months.
That's for pretty much, yeah. Well, the only one I know that, well, there's two, like DJ's pretty successful at it, and Wink Inc. They're the two that are really, but they're also more personable and friendly about it too. I'm a dick when it comes to mystery boxes. If I don't like them, I flat out say I don't like them, and it's like,
Freaky Louie. All right, buddy. Nice. I'm glad you're here. Australia rules. I don't know. I haven't been, but
me neither. I mean, it's full of ex-prisoners, so it's got to be great.
Yeah. See, okay, well, actually, Lee is now confirming Australia is shit, so I think he should know.
He would know.
Tyler loves mystery boxes.
He loves especially the Comic Tom boxes. Those are his favorite.
So I was thinking, since you guys actually have a game show, I was thinking that we could play a game show. Sort of a little game show called Garbage Game Show.
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
Sorry, that was the wrong intro.
Was it? Was it really?
It actually was. Garbage game show.
Game show.
Garbage game show. Welcome to my garbage game show, you piece of shit.
Yeah, I can't tell you've watched Tim and Eric at all.
So this is Garbage Game Show. Last week I played a game with Lee and Tyler, game I pulled out of the trash, and the idea was I was going to go digging through the garbage this week to find a new game to play, but I didn't find one. So we'll have to play that same game this time. Or we could potentially play Golden Girls Monopoly.
Oh,
unfortunately, Monopoly takes like 7 hours to play, so
it does.
I have to do that another day. So it looks like we're stuck with this trash game
called
Geek Out.
Oh boy.
which is, again, a game I did find in the garbage for good reason. It is a trivia game based on geeky stuff, pop culture, whatever. Sort of like Trivial Pursuit, except that it's a piece of shit version of Trivial Pursuit because there's no answers at all. It's entirely subjective. You just it works on the honor system, essentially. So if you guys are interested, we can play a couple rounds of this.
Let's do it. Bring it on.
Yes, sir.
All right. So there's five topics. I was going to say Lee and Tyler had dice. But you know what? I'm just going to roll for everyone.
Perfect.
Because it doesn't even matter. okay. For example, a lot of the questions are like name three Batman villains or something. There was one question last week. There was a lot of debate over it. It was name four disabled, comic book characters, and it was a topic of hot debate over whether Professor X was in fact disabled, or because he's telepathic, he was just sort of convincing everyone that he needed the wheelchair, but really he was walking around the whole time, right? Ah. He's capable of that. So I'm going to go, maybe I'll just go first.
All right.
I rolled, what is that? A white. I think white means I get to pick any category. And I'm going to go with, let's go with comics, blue. And I'm just going to totally pick out something random here. Name two characters from Archie Comics. I mean, that's super easy. Archie and Jughead. So there you go.
Jughead?
Pretty sure that's exactly how it's pronounced, too. Yeah.
It is. Yeah. See, if you guys... Now, here's the thing. If you think that I'm wrong, like if you think it's Jughead and not Jughead, you got to call me out on that, and then I don't get the points. So,
we have to give a shit?
Anyway, so it's going to be... we get these points, -2 points, as you can see, -2. And so that was just to show you what it's like. Anyways, I'll say.
That's Jughead for you.
That's Jughead.
Yeah. I went to art school. Can you tell?
Yes.
that was like 30 seconds, too. That was top notch.
Yes.
let's go with Taylor. Yep. First, you rolled black, which is miscellaneous.
Oh, excellent. Well, all right.
Oh, wow. Okay. So
that's what I like.
Do you want an easy one or a difficult one?
Oh, give me a difficult one so I look like an idiot. Let's do this.
Okay. Actually, no. Okay. This isn't too difficult, but you know what? It's six. You got to name six animated Disney villains.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Here's the thing is I've never really watched a lot of Disney.
Yeah.
Cause I don't have kids. Cause that's why I don't give a shit. So Cruella.
Yeah. That's one.
Scar, right? That's that Lion King villain.
I think so.
Bambi's dad. He left Bambi. So he's a dick. Yeah. We're calling absentee fathers out here. Who else?
Nemo's parents for losing him.
Yep.
Yeah. Wait,
is that Disney or is that Pixar? Are they?
They're all the same, right? They're at the same. They're all. Woody from Toy Story for like trying to unionize. And yep. I got nothing else. I'm just gonna call myself a failure on this one because I don't know Disney movies for shit.
I'm gonna say it was that. I think that was six. I'm gonna give you negative 2 points. Anyway.
Thanks. I was like two. I think I got maybe one actual villain, but you know,
that's okay because there's actually you can play the Dracula card, which is actually according to Dracula rules, at least some of them should be made up.
Oh so, well.
So I think you got the negative two there. All right, next up is Jason. You rolled blue, which is whatever. Comic books.
Whatever comic books.
Clearly rigged.
Yeah, this isn't rigged at all. How can it be rigged when there's no answers on the back? Okay. Here we go. Do you want like... do you want an easy one, just a freebie, or do you want a real like rigged type question? This is something you would throw out there for sure.
Right, let's give myself my own medicine. Let's get a taste of it.
I'm not making this up. Name two comic book pregnancies.
Let's see. Sue Storm and Reed Richards. Their son, right? And then let's go with Jean Grey and Scott Summers. Didn't they have a kid? And didn't he become like a Omega level mutant or something? So
that's Cable.
Cable's one of them. And then I thought there was another one too, but maybe I'm wrong.
Well, there is Nathan Summers, right?
Nathan Summers is Cable.
Is Cable, and there is another one.
I can't think of his name now.
Nolan? I don't know.
That sounds like a supervillain.
Someone in the chat will know. Anyways, I don't know. I guess Biggie's saying I won the rap battle. Anyways. Yeah. Who the hell is Pongo? Oh,
doesn't 101 Dalmatians. Eggs? That counts as a pregnancy.
101 egg. Dalmatians, yeah.
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 Rachel
Summers. If he leaves her, imagine how much child support he's going to have to pay.
Yeah.
Rachel Summers, thank you, Ignacio.
Rachel Summers, there you go.
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
All right. I'm going to go with blue, which is comic books again. And this is great because I get to look for my own question. Oh, okay. Four superheroes that wear green as their primary costume color. Green Lantern, obviously. Green Arrow. I think that's
some low hanging fruit.
I think that's
it. Right?
There's like two of them. They're asking for four. Swamp Thing, his costume's green. And
Man Thing.
Yeah, but that's too close to Swamp Thing. I gotta think of something a little more different.
But Green Arrow, Green Lantern are very far apart.
and a green character. Let's see.
Michelangelo,
yeah. I'll go with that. I get my negative 2 points for that.
There you go.
Sure. Two of them absolutely were costumes and not their skin. So that was good.
But it's not the two you think.
Peter Pan, Ignacio got it.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Peter Pan. Yeah.
I would have gone Polaris.
Not a comic book character there, Ignacio, but that's all right.
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
All right. So Taylor, you're up with
green. Well, give me another bullshit category again. Let's do this.
You got green, which is fantasy.
Oh, my life's favorite. A fantasy.
Yeah. Let's see. Oh, wow, that's a good one.
Oh boy.
Name two items that kill a person when they are looked at.
Jesus Christ. Medusa's head and a basilisk. Wait, or that's the other way around. The bat's supposed to have to look at them. I don't know. I'm still going with it. That's all I got. So,
okay, I'll give you negative 1 point for that.
I'll take negative one.
What about the last arc, right? The arc from Raiders of the Last Arc?
Oh, yeah, that probably do it too. Yeah.
Oh,
I was thinking like fantasy.
Melt your face.
Too late. Yeah. Okay, you're getting one. I had to rip this in half. So you get negative one. Here we go. That's gonna work. Sort of. There we go. And now, Jason, you get yellow. Have we asked that yet? No, yellow is sci-fi.
Nice.
Ooh.
There's actually some really tough questions in here. nice. Star Wars.
Nanu. Love it.
I can't do that, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. There's legit some in here that I could not answer. So
perfect. Let's give it to Jason.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That's a good one. This is a good one. Name four fictional sci-fi corporations. Huh?
Sci-fi corporations.
Yeah.
Let's go with CyberLink or CyberNet.
CyberNet, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, that's one.
God, four.
Yeah, definitely, John.
CyberNet, is that RoboCop, right? That's Cyber... Wait, that's Terminator.
He worked for the Detroit police, didn't he?
Well, that was, I can't think of the.
I mean, that's an evil corporation, the cops.
Yeah.
There you go. Skynet. There you go. Shatter.
Skynet.
Let's go with the Decepticons.
Yeah. I'll accept that.
One more.
Oh, Alan Yutani. What's that? Sorry, I was just coughing there.
Let's go with the, God, I can't think of another one.
You can use the Dracula rule of you got to make one up now.
Okay. I'll make one up.
Yeah.
We'll go with, the Evil Taylor Winder Corporation.
Yeah. It's an S.
They're a bunch of bastards.
They are. They're all dicks.
Would also
they can be fine every now and then.
Yeah.
OCP. God, there you go.
Yeah, OCP. Yeah.
I would have gone Weyland Yutani.
Yeah, Weyland Yutani from Aliens. Yeah. So I think Jason, you're only gonna get I think you get two for that.
Yeah, you got two.
Yeah, why the hell not? And
don't you dare say Family Dollar. Family Dollars. $5 is amazing. That's where you get your pool noodles for mailing slabs.
IHOP. Red. I got red. What's actually, have we asked all of these yet? Oh, red is games. Yeah, this is going to suck.
A game about games? Gross.
Yeah.
No.
Okay. Okay, like for example, four tabletop games with a Star Wars theme. Star Wars Monopoly, Star Wars Trivial Pursuit, Star Wars Game of Life, Star Wars Star Wars.
Hope he is your father. Go back four squares.
And I'm going to say this garbage game. Because there's
a garbage
question in it. So that's my four for sure.
This is like, and those games you play at a fucking bar that are on TV. This is horrible.
This is it.
I kind of love it, but it's horrible.
I think there's a reason I found it in the garbage.
Yeah. Star Wars Doctor's Office?
Yes. What did I just roll here? All right, so... Taylor, I'm going to give you, what is that? Another miscellaneous.
All right. Bring it.
Yeah, some of these are just not even worth asking. Probably most of them. Okay. Name, this is a question about television.
Oh boy. All right.
Name two television shows that have lasted over 10 seasons.
Oh God. The Price is Right, bitch.
Yeah, absolutely.
And The Simpsons. I'm going with the, yeah.
There you go.
That is correct.
Yeah, that's right. I threw out The Price is Right. That's right.
Yeah. I don't know who that's directed towards. That's an interesting question.
Was MASH more than 10 years, Jeff? I don't know. I never got into that show.
Anyways, who else? Biggie's here, Jeff Schultz. How you doing? And now we got Chip Gettler up in here.
Yeah, we got a big Chicago crowd joining us.
Gettler. What is up, Mr. Gettler? The white shadow.
Yeah, Chip is missing out on this awesome game. Okay. Maybe, Chip, ask one more.
Maybe next time you could have the Chicago, Jeff Schultz versus Chip Gettler.
Yeah. Ask one or two more questions. Why the hell not? You got another comic book question. I should have just made them all comic book questions to do my own rigged, but you know what? It's too late for that now. This thing sucks. Name four comic book characters with silver hair.
Wow. Ooh, the silver foxes.
Let's go with Quicksilver.
Quicksilver,
how about Silver Sable?
Yeah, and they both have silver in their names.
And what about Silver Surfer? I mean, does that count as hair?
No, he doesn't even have balls.
Yeah.
So
if
what about Rogue? Is that white or silver? We'll just call it silver.
Sure.
Batman's getting old. He's got to have some silver in there.
Yeah. I think so.
That's four.
There you go.
Scott Summers, right? He has silver in his hair too. Mr. Fantastic. Mr. Fantastic and Scott Summers. Wrong guy. Oh,
Storm. There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think if I tally up the points here, it looks like we all got -1,000 points.
Oh, because shit.
This game sucks, which means we all lose.
Tiebreaker?
We can do a tiebreaker. And we all have to answer the same question, and whoever answers better. Okay, we can each do one. Name four. No, let's do a comic book one. All right. Oh, okay. Here's a real legit rigged style question. Name six characters created by Jack Kirby. There you go.
Let's see. Incredible Hulk.
Venom.
Buzzy.
Carnage.
Mr. Miracle.
Mr. Miracle for sure, yeah.
Omac, Orion.
Sandman. The old school Sandman, not Neil Gaiman Sandman, obviously.
All those Ducci Eternals, like Cersei and Gwenom. And,
the silver-haired ones.
Pikachu, definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
So, Chip, when you say that, do you mean that this game is a piece of garbage? Because it is.
So he's calling the comic book garbage. What
are
you saying?
Yeah, what are you doing?
Screw you, Chip.
Screw you, Chip. So, anyways, I think we got all six.
Yeah, that's probably right. We got at least 12.
We got like 13 of them. Like a whole bunch. Dozen.
And I think that's a good place to wrap up this version of Garbage Game Show. The garbage game show. Welcome to my garbage game show, you piece of shit. Never gonna get old. There was something in the chat I meant to
Freaky Louie's actually like legit answering questions and stuff,
right? Yeah. Oh yeah, I mean he just,
yeah,
it's too bad you're not here, Lou. He would get like negative 2,000 points for that.
Yeah, he would double this up for sure.
Oh, see, look, now he's backpedaling here, right? No white shadow. Yeah, FF, all of X-Men.
Yep.
All right, and thank you, Ignacio.
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
Thank you, Biggie. Yeah, I mean, I think that was in my opinion right up there with Rigged in terms of
difficulty
of the questions and how
probably well, better just because the host is way better.
I don't know, Jason. You could have named yourself as a silver-haired superhero because you got the.
I miss moving the hair out of my eyes.
Yeah, trust me, it's not worth it. That's the problem. I should be drinking. That would help.
Yeah. This is mostly. I don't know, vodka.
Mostly vodka.
Yeah. Anyways, there was something I was going to bring up and I totally forgot. The main thing was we got through Garbage Game Show unscathed. I'm really hoping I find another game in the garbage soon, because although this is fine, this has been good for two episodes. I'm hoping I can find something even worse in the trash.
I just want to know which dumpsters you're diving in to get these, because
I honestly don't remember. There's so many that
nothing's greater than family.
What's that?
No, I'm just doing the stupid Fast Furious meme that's been going around, because he said blood is don't ignore me.
So any idea when we might expect I guess the next episode of Rigged?
My guess is within, I would say, in the next month for sure. I would like to bring it back within the next month. Like I said, I really, really want to do the Whacked Comics episode of Rigged. So I need to reach out to Lee and Tyler about that and work out the possibilities of that again. So, and then, bringing Rig back is something I definitely want to do for sure.
I definitely looking forward to that, especially a Whack Comics one. But in the meantime, I will be holding it down with Garbage Game Show.
There you go. Yeah.
The possibilities are endless.
Well, Sundays at 6:30 are open right now, so you can just fill that time slot with your.
I think I might have to.
Yeah,
Lee says they're ready, so we'll have to get with them on that. Taylor.
Yeah, all right.
Tyler and Taylor and
that won't get fucking confusing.
Never, especially when Tyler tries to be Taylor.
Yeah,
or if I try to be Tyler, what about that?
Yeah, that too.
We can get all meta. I can't grow the chin hair though, so I'm screwed.
Can you dress up in a wig and?
Yeah, and I can Sharpie the shit out of my face, so that'll work.
I think you have to now.
I think I probably do. Not tonight. I got to.
Yeah, they take a little bit longer to get here.
Show up to sell a house and you got like Sharpie all over your face.
I got a Rob Fat Stacks evil mustache drawn on. And,
So where was I going with this? Oh yeah. Sunday at 8:30 is open. All right. I'm taking it. Actually, I'm not, because I like what I've done here, for example, is I've just kind of wedged myself into that usual suspects time slot and just, you know, seeing how many viewers I can steal away from those guys, I guess from you guys, right?
Those damn usual suspects.
Yeah. But yeah,
it's,
I guess
it's all gonna be Gary talking about Conan and, you know.
Oh, is he a fan of Conan?
Oh, you didn't hear that now. He's a mild fan.
He likes Conan a little bit, and he might like Red Sonja just a tad.
Yeah. It's funny because we were on Tomorrow Show together last night, and I don't think he really talked about Conan once. He might have mentioned it briefly, but I think that's because Lasso took over with all the Wonder Woman talk. It was like 3 hours. We're talking about Wonder Woman for 3 hours.
I didn't know there was that much Wonder Woman to talk about. But.
No, that was a great show though. But yeah, I think I'm gonna wrap it up here. I gotta take care of this mess I made. I'm not even gonna get into it. Yeah, I'd like to thank you guys for coming on, definitely.
Oh, thanks for having me.
I'm glad you guys got to try my Garbage Game Show, before we go. Garbage Game Show. Game show. Garbage Game Show. Welcome to the Garbage Game Show. This is my show. My show.
Garbage.
The trash show.
Garbage.
The trash bag. Leave.
Garbage. Don't do the Garbage Game Show.
The Garbage Show, you trash bag.
Welcome.
Welcome to my Garbage Game Show, you piece of shit.
That ending was the best.
Yeah. Thank you, Ignacio.
Barbara Gordon, you hawk. My name is Ignacio.
Oh, I almost forgot. I had another sponsor as well.
I'm terrified.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
I had to do it. I had to do it.
Your sponsors are paying you good money to sponsor. So, yeah.
Right. Oh, you got to save the best for last.
Yeah. I play that for free, actually. I have to pay Burke to play that. But yeah, again, guys, thanks for coming on. Is there, I know, Jason, so you're still, I guess, like kind of like on hiatus from YouTube technically.
Rob's bringing back, we're bringing back sidekicks.comics, and it's going to be bi-weekly. I'll probably pop on with the usual suspects here and there. I definitely want to bring back Rig. So
yeah,
more content for me coming, just not like I was, you know, previously.
Yeah, fair enough. But I know we're all looking forward to seeing to having you back. You know, I love your channel, so yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Appreciate it.
Oh my goddamn camera. That's, we're at the hour mark, folks, because that's about when my camera decides to tick.
All right, buddy. So Taylor, is there anything What is tell everyone what do you got going on? Oh, there we go.
It's all about me. I open a box of some random crap every Monday. I do trade paperback Tuesdays, where if you trade paperbacks, I usually give them away. So you should watch that. You can win some trade paperbacks. And then Wednesday, I get cranky and review every comic I read. So, you know, that's about it.
Yeah, that will. I do. Like I said before, I think you are one of my favorite sources for figuring out what I am going to get on New Comic Book Day. Not so much what I'm going to buy, but what I'm not going to buy. So,
yeah, children of the ad, fucking horrible.
Your cranky reviews definitely probably save me some money better spent elsewhere.
I suffer, so you don't have to.
Yes.
Way to take and, it.
We thank you for that.
I'm like Comic Book Jesus that way.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
If I don't lose subs for that one, I never will.
Yeah. Anyways, and thank you to everyone in the chat, everyone who's been watching. This has been episode 2 of Casual Dracula, and it's a complete hot mess. I have no idea what I'm doing with this show. And it will continue to be that way, I think, from now until the end of time. So, you know, you can expect a little of this, a little of that. I'll drink martini or champagne. maybe even some of this. And when the toy gets broken, I'll simply throw it away. We're designed for living, for living. We're designed for living, for living. I would pay really good money to see Taylor do that exact same dance.
Oh, God.
No. I'm Jughead now.
Yes, Jughead. I love it. I love it. And I think this is an excellent way to end the show, with Tyler pointing out that this show is garbage. And that I could not agree more. I love it. And thank you for watching this piece of garbage, Tyler. And I couldn't have done it without you. And you were one of the biggest pieces of trash I've ever had on this show, Tyler. So, and that was Tyler, not Taylor.
That's all right. I can be the second biggest piece of trash. Every week you should have some variation of Tyler or Taylor on.
Yeah.
Like Taylor Swift. Or, you know, just
yes.
Just throwing out there.
Thank you.
Barbara Gordon. New Hawk. My name is Ignacio.
All right, guys, I think that's gonna be it. Thank you all for watching, and thank you, Jason and Taylor, for coming on. I had a great time. I hope you guys enjoyed a convo, a little garbage game show. Yeah,
it was fun. Thank you.
Yeah, that was fun. Thanks for having me.
All right, awesome. All right, guys, take care and have a good night, and I will leave you with this. Feels so good. You're lying here next to me. A whole wet room. You have no idea how it feels. My hands just won't.
Barbara Gordon, New Hawk. My name is Ignacio.